praise, oh God, like never before. Hallelujah. Take off the limits. Take off the chains, oh God. We bless you this morning that we're going further in you. We're going higher in you. We're going deeper in you this morning, Lord God. And Father God, we just pray over every minister of the gospel that is present on this morning, Lord God. Stir up every good gift, every spiritual gift, oh God. You said, oh God, you will give us the words. You will fill our mouths with the words, oh God. Oh Father, so fill us this morning, Lord God. Our hearts are open to hear from you. Oh God, our souls are open to you and you alone, Lord God, and close to everything else, oh God. Speak to us and speak through us this morning, Lord God, that we may encourage the hearts of your people, oh God. We bless you this morning. Hallelujah, Jesus. We thank you for all that are to come and that are on their way. Move every hindrance, move every stop in the name of Jesus. We bless you this morning. We love you and we praise you, oh God. We lift up the visionary, Lord God. We lift up our apostle, Lord God, who choose to lead us outside of the four walls. Bless her this morning like never before, oh God. Oh Father, we thank you for the vision coming forth, oh God, in the name of Jesus. We bless you for our elder this morning. Hallelujah, Jesus. Use him in a mighty way this morning. Hallelujah. And laying on of hands and speaking of your word, oh God. Use him in a mighty way. Hallelujah, Jesus. We bless you this morning for moving amongst us, oh God. For this being, oh God, a day to go down in history, glory to God, of a great move of God. Our expectancy is open, Lord God. We're expecting you to move in an unusual way, in a mighty way, Lord God. Hallelujah. You have not called us to this place for not, Lord God. We come against every enemy of fear and intimidation in the name of Jesus. Every demon of hell, we speak to you now and command you to loose the people of God in the name of Jesus. Loose them to come, hallelujah, and drink of the water of salvation. Drink of the fountain of living waters in the name of Jesus. Loose the lips of your servants this morning in the name of Jesus. We pray over every teenager in our presence, even the little ones, Lord God. Use them mightily, Lord God. We pray that their hearts will be open to you, Lord God. Turn us all back to you, Lord. Turn our hearts back to you and you alone. Saturate us in your presence. Even though we're in an open space, Lord, we expect your spirit to saturate this place, oh God. The very block, the very neighborhood, Lord God. Saturate the atmosphere with your glory. Hallelujah, Jesus. We're expecting you this morning and we love you. We give you honor and we give you praise for all that you are prepared to do. Hallelujah. It is in Jesus' mighty name alone that we pray. Amen. Come on and give him an amen. 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 Hallelujah. Glory to God. Oh, Jesus. Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. We're going to have our declaration of faith this morning. If my eyes fail me not. I can see it. Praise the Lord.
Glory to God.
All right, y'all ready to declare our faith?
Amen.
Are you ready to declare your faith?
Yes.
All right, let's declare. In Christ, I am anointed and a powerful person of God. I am a joint heir with Jesus Christ and more than a conqueror. I am a doer of the word of God and a channel for his blessings. Since God is for me, who can be against me? I am blessed coming in and I'm blessed going out. My enemies are fleeing before me. God has commanded his blessings upon my storehouses. He has opened his good treasures and I shall lend and not borrow. I am the head and not the tail, empowered by God to make wealth, that God's covenant be established in the earth. I dwell in the secret place where his protection and provision brings the supply. God is my refuge and my fortress. I am not afraid of the snare of the fowler. Therefore, no evil shall befall me, and no plague shall come nigh my dwelling. God has given his angels charge over me, and they are bearing me up in their hands, lest I dash my foot against the stone. I am free because I choose to continue in the things of God. By obeying the word of God, I am a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a peculiar person called out of darkness into his marvelous light. It is the peace of God that makes me holy in every way, and my spirit, soul, and body will be kept blameless until my Lord Jesus Christ comes again. It is my desire that I gain, maintain, and increase in the things of God. Therefore, I shall prosper and be in good health, even as my soul prospers, because Christ has healed me. Therefore, no cancer, no sugar diabetes, no heart disease, no high blood pressure, no sickness, no afflictions, no infections, or any other disease cannot enter or stay in my body. I am without spot or blemish, an intercessor, an ambassador, the righteousness of God. I am saved and washed in the blood of Jesus. No weapon formed against me shall prosper, and every tongue that rises against me in judgment, the Lord shall condemn. This is my heritage as a servant of the Lord, and my righteousness is through Christ. I am saved from wrath by him and justified by the blood of the Lamb. Lord, I pray that those may prosper that love Jerusalem, and that peace will be within them and prosperity in their house, according to Psalm 122, 6 through 9. Hallelujah. Come on and give God glory. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Jesus. Are y'all ready to worship under the heavens today? Are y'all ready to worship and give God some praises today?
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah, Jesus. Glory be to God.
Glory to God. Let's go into worship. Glory to God. We're going to go into corporate worship this morning together. Glory be to God. We'll worship along with the track and the music. Glory to God. How many excited about Jesus? Glory be to God. How many excited about being alive? The fact that you can breathe, the fact that you can see, the fact that in him you have your being. Glory be to God. It's enough to say thank you, Lord. Oh, come on and open your mouth and say hallelujah. 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 Glory to God. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Every praise is to our God.
not like you.
Not like you.
Into the darkness.
Into the darkness you shine.
Out of the ashes you rise.
Out of the ashes we rise. There's no one like you.
Oh, I love it.
There's none like you.
Your supplier, your Jehovah.
I love you forever.
Need to have his own mic. Glory to God. We got three more mics. Hallelujah. Glory to God. I love you forever. I want you forever. I want to serve you forever. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Truly, he's a good God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And he's certainly worthy to be praised. If you think God is worthy of your praise, when you feel it's hard that you hard for you to get into praise, just think about the goodness of Jesus. Think about all that he's done for you. Then your soul will begin to count upon above, hallelujah, your circumstances, and lead you to the fountain of life where you can drink, hallelujah, where you can feel the freshness, glory to God, of his presence, oh God, hallelujah, waiting to be poured out upon you. Amen. Out of all the ministers in the house, don't tell me not one minister ain't looked in the scripture and don't have a word to bring to the Lord. We got three mics on the right. I ain't preaching today, glory to God. Hallelujah, Jesus. This is your opportunity. Each minister get your own mic. Hallelujah. And let the Lord use you, glory to God, to give him praise, whether you testify, whether you're giving him honor, whether you're just encouraging, glory, might drop a word of wisdom down in your soul. A word of knowledge for those that are sitting in a bar. Glory to God. Hallelujah. And the Lord may lead you, hallelujah, into a prayer covering over this atmosphere, over this realm. This is our Northwest territory. Glory to God. We cover this area in prayer. Hallelujah. So the Lord may lead a prophetic word out of your mouth to speak over this region and this territory in which we do all the time. But the more we do, glory to God, we can never do too much. Amen, Brother Carter. You ready to come and bless us with some encouraging words? Whatever the Lord has given you, let the Lord use you. Amen. Glory to God.
Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. Who knows that God himself is a God of timing? God has his own timing and not man's timing. Okay, so I thank God for our apostle having the vision to bring us outside the four walls, because the church itself is merely a refilling station, as she tells us, each and every time we enter into the sanctuary. The true church is in you. That's what we taught. That's what I believe. How about you? Okay, so the true church is in us. Now, God is funny. And throughout your busy schedule, throughout the week, God will speak if you have an ear to hear him. And what I did this weekend, I said, God, you know what? I know I've been neglecting you. That song rung in my spirit all week long since we left last Sunday. Open the eyes of my heart, Lord. And I've been saying that repeatedly, over and over and over. Sometimes you have to be careful what you ask for too in God. Listen, what I asked, I said, Lord, he led me to say, okay, I have 12 disciples. I had 12 disciples. One betrayed me, and then I replaced him with another. And I looked and said, each and every one probably has a personality of one of those 12 disciples. And I looked and I said, which one of these disciples am I? And I asked the Lord, I said, out of all the disciples, which one was I? And he told me to look. And as I looked, I saw that Matthew, out of all the disciples, I would have to say runs a close comparison to me. First of all, he was a tax collector or a merchant. That's who I am in my daily life. One thing about Matthew was also an evangelist. He was also an apostle and a writer of the gospel of Matthew. Matthias, or Matthew, which is a gift of Yahweh. Now, say, Carl, why would you choose Matthew? Okay, like I said, I work in the marketplace. I'm always asking for money. Even before I came into the understanding of Christ. But one thing about Matthew, once he came to the understanding of Christ, he never turned and he never wavered. He never wavered, not at all. I take that back. He did waver as all the others did when Jesus was being led to Calvary. when he was being crucified. But one thing about it, God is a forgiving God. Now, I'm not going to bore you. I'm just going to tell you, and I'm going to encourage you to seek out the scriptures and look at the 12 disciples and say, which one am I? Because if at all, if you're gonna look for some encouragement and leadership, who better than those who walked along with Jesus himself? So choose the one who you are, embrace the one who you are, and let the glory of the God, the glory of God, not the God, the only God, let the glory of God arise in you, and you stand firm. And thank you. Thank you. Hearing that wind? Y'all hearing that wind? Okay. Now, also another attributes of Matthew. He wrote the Gospels of Matthew, and he was named Levi before he was called by Jesus. Matthias, which means the gift of God. Now, as I stated, he abandoned the pleasures of this world for the promise of eternal life. He was also a missionary spreading the good news to the other countries abroad. His hometown was Capernaum, C-A-P-E-R-N-A-U-M. I also did a couple more studies on the other disciples, but that would be at another date. Now, I want to leave on that note. I want to say thank you, God, for giving us the opportunity to step outside these four walls. Anyone that's in earshot and you need some refreshment, you know the truth. Maybe someone hasn't told you the truth. Maybe you're going through something. Only you know and God knows. So you listen to what's going on around here, and you don't be ashamed, because everyone here is welcome. And we say this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen, amen, amen. Amen. Come on, ministers. You're on the spot. If you're a minister, I need you to get up and give a word. Amen. Hallelujah. Minister Michelle was next. You need a mic. Oh, no, 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 no. Go over there and grab your own mic. Y'all got it.
Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
Thank God for this day, this beautiful day.
Amen.
I'm so blessed to be here. I thank God for waking me up this morning, starting me on my way. I am Minister Michelle, and I'm so blessed today to be here. God brought us home from a trip in a storm yesterday evening. God is so good. I am so grateful. I'm at awe with God. I mean, God, he just... We don't even have to worry about stuff. When we keep our mind on God, we stay prayed up, we stay read up, we stay doing the things with our mind steadfasted on God in his will, he will take care of our every need. We don't even have to worry about nothing. It's already prepared. The way I was on my way to move some stuff out of my storage yesterday, and I was worried about how I'm going to get a truck. And I was looking for, the wrong truck. He know what I needed, and he supplied just what I needed. I'm running around calling around looking for a 17 foot. Here it is. He already had a 20 foot prepared for me. On my way going where I had to go, just what I needed. That 17 foot was what? 17, 18, 19, 20. Who were 3 foot too short. Amen. He had just what I need prepared for me waiting. Lord, a brand new truck.
Hallelujah.
Very nice and comfortably. I didn't even want to get out of it and get in my own, to pull my own trailer. I'm going to throw the truck on here from Hope Sound. I drove it from Sebastian to Hope Sound. She drove it from Hope Sound to here. I didn't even want to get out the truck. It was so comfortable. But God is good. And I'm so thankful. It's a privilege to tell of his goodness. And I will tell it everywhere I go. And when I was at the store yesterday, we were waiting on my mom at a Hess and Sebastian. My brother Byron, y'all know Byron Smoker. He's looking for a cigarette, right? So he asked the guy for a cigarette. I said, well, thank you for giving him that. He has cigarettes, but my mom is not here to give it to him. He's talking about cigarette. God, forgive me. But I'm going somewhere with this. But anyway, I said, thank you, sir. God bless you. Oh, I don't believe in God. I said, why not? Why you don't believe in God? He said, nobody never did nothing for me. All my life, I did everything for myself.
Wow.
I said, where do you think this rain coming from that's pouring down right now? He said, oh, that's just trying to say just scientists or whatever. I'm saying, no, that's God. That's God's rain.
Amen.
He reflourishes and he replenishes earth with this rain. I said, who breath do you take when you breathe in? He said, who breath you breathing in and out? And then he didn't want to hear what I was saying, but he got on in his car. But I said, anyway, God is real, and I'm going to pray that you begin to start believing in God because he is real and he loves you. He got on in his car and closed the door. He would listen to me, but it was just a word I needed to give out right then. And I thank God for that opportunity because somebody else going to come and plant that same seed in his spirit. And I pray that it flourishes and it grows. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
I'm going to be short and brief. Just a little encouragement. And I'm saying again, good morning, Holy Spirit. I love the Lord. He is so good. And I'm so thankful. This is the day that the Lord has made. I will rejoice and be glad in it. I am so thankful for Jesus. The word of Psalm 61, honor the God and he will honor you. No matter how things look to us, it is not the picture God has for our lives. He has a brighter picture than ours. And it's not dark and cloudy. The way we see it is not that way. It's beautiful. It's wonderfully made. And as clear as crystal. The plans and the way of the Lord, what he has in store for us, for our life. Them that honor me, I will honor them, saith the Lord. And they that despise me shall be lightly esteemed. 1 Samuel 2:30. Colossians 3:20 says, and whatever you do, do it heartily as to the Lord, not unto man. When we do things to man, like we're doing it for man, you know, flesh get in the way. And when we are in a situation to be a blessing to God, we should always be willing to give our time and do our best, because when we are looking for something for God, what we want? We want his best, right? We're looking for God to give us his best. So when we do for him, we need to give him our best. Do it wholeheartedly unto him, not unto man. Okay? Because when we are looking for something for God, don't say that. So we give him our best in whatever we do, to do it wholeheartedly unto him, not to man. Knowing that if we think in our mind we are doing something for man, we will walk in the flesh and do it any old kind of way. We'll just do it any kind of way. Somebody say, Pastor, now he tell you, pick that up and put it over there. You're going to go and kick it over there behind his back. That's not your best. You're not giving your best when you do that. What's wrong with stooping on down? You too lazy to stoop down and pick it up and do it the way you were told. That's disobedient. That's witchcraft. Because you kicking it. Okay? He asked you to pick it up and do it over there. And you're going to take and kick it over there? Oh my God. What kind of way is that? That's the old kind of way. That's walking in the flesh. So we must remember, it is important of doing it God's way, to receive blessing from our God. And I'm not thinking this person is, okay. And we're not thinking this person is trying to control us, or that they just want to have something to tell us to do. If they're your boss, they do have some power over you.
That's right.
They have power to sign your paycheck. Okay. Okay, so they can take control of me. That's why I truly thank God for Jesus, because we have a way of escape, and that is the word of God. And it teaches us how to carry ourselves and how to treat ourselves. There's a saying that what would Jesus do? Or how would he handle this situation? So we must be very careful how we react, because at any given moment, we may have to do a service just for Christ. You never know.
That's
He could come in all forms. He could supernaturally appear right here, right now, as an old rugged man, a mere man, bent over, a drunk. And how you going to treat that person? Are you going to tell, in the Bible say, are you going to tell the man walking in the fine clothes in the jewelry, you're going to say, sit right here in my beautiful seat. And then you're going to tell the man, the drunk man, sit right here beneath my feet. Because of the way he looked, you're going to tell him to sit at your feet? No, that's not God. That's not God's way. God don't treat us like that, and we shouldn't treat his people like that.
That's right. Amen.
Okay? So we have to do a service to Christ himself. So we have to be ready. We're not there to fool around as if we have no purpose. We have to stay moving and going about our Father's business and perfecting it daily. Because we can't be perfect in our ways, in our walk, in our walk with God. You know, we can't be perfect. If the Bible said we can be perfect, he said, walk perfect before me. Okay? So let's do things as unto God and not unto man. In Amen. Jesus' name. Anybody else got a word? You got something in your belly to come up with? Glory to God. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Minister Michelle, for encouraging us with those encouraging words. And Brother Carl, for giving us those encouraging words. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Prophetess is coming next. Amen.
Praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
The Bible says, if I don't cry out, the rocks will cry out in my place. Praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
Y'all still sitting down so comfortable. Praise the Lord, somebody.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord, everybody. Oh, my soul shall make her boast in the Lord. Hallelujah. If I don't have Christ to talk about, I got nothing to talk about. Hallelujah. The Bible says no good thing dwell in this flesh. I don't care how well put together I may look. I do take pride in keeping myself looking a little nice. But I don't care how well every hair is in place. I don't care how well every eyelash or eyebrow is in place. I don't care how good my walk might look to some. It doesn't matter how well my speech is. Glory to God, how well educated I am. It doesn't matter how beautifully I speak in tongues. It doesn't matter how well I can explicate the word of God. It doesn't matter how well I can pray and stir up the good gifts. All that matters is that God is good. Amen. My soul shall make her boast in the Lord. Hallelujah. I boast in his goodness, in his glory, his mercies, his grace, his wonders. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Even as you begin to talk about that storm on yesterday. My God, the way God is so awesome in the way that he moves. And we were out celebrating our fifth wedding anniversary this weekend. Amen. I wish I could sing. I sing that song. They said I wouldn't make it. They said I wouldn't be here today. They said I'd never amount to anything. But I'm glad to say that I'm on my way. And I'm growing more and more each day. There are many that started out with me. But now they've gone astray. But I'm still holding on. Come on, saints, I'm still holding on to his hand. Why? Because he is holding on to me. Glory be to God.
My testimony for a lot of years was I'm still here. We would have testimony service at our old church, and I would simply stand up and say, I'm still here. That's my testimony. Because in my youth, I was very foolish. I know some of y'all had it together, got saved early and stayed in the way. But in my youth, I was very foolish. I was very promiscuous. And I could have been taken out by any type of disease at any moment. I was an alcoholic at the age of 13. I could have been taken out by alcohol. I was very foolish, running around with this person and that person, addicted to the fast life, addicted to attention in the wrong way. And I got involved with a young man who was already involved with another young lady, and she was crazy, and she's still crazy. And she got a carload of her friends one night. I'm just driving, riding. My baby's in the car. She got a carload of her friends one night and decided they was going to jump me. That was going to be the end of me that night. I had no idea. And the car was similar to a car that my cousin had at the time. And they came behind me and flashed the lights, bumped the horn, and I'm stopping. And he was in the car with me. He said, don't stop this car. I'm like, that's my... He said, don't stop this car. So I didn't stop the car. So we ended up on the high-speed chase for about 15, 20 minutes through the streets of Del Rey. They chased me and chased me and chased me. He ended up having, I ain't proud of this, y'all, but he ended up having to actually take out a gun and fire shots at them to get them to stop. I mean, she came one time with an iron rod and all kind of crazy stuff. She used to carry knives. She was known for carrying knives. She really wanted to do away with me. Over a boy, okay? And so, God has spared my life in so many ways. We was just talking yesterday about the accidents and different things that I've been involved in and how God has really just had his hand on my life. And that's my testimony, is that I'm still here. That's still my testimony. I'm still serving God. I'm still in my right mind. I still got a mind to praise him. I got a voice to praise him. I got a will and a desire to praise him and him alone. That's my testimony. Glory to God. God has brought me through so much. My children sitting right there. I was 16 when I had the first one, 19 when I had the second one. I have been through so much. But in it all, God is good. And I didn't understand or even realize the calling that was on my life. Perhaps if I had been in a ministry where the gifts of God were flourishing, I would have known at an earlier age. But I don't take any of it for granted. I don't regret a thing at all. I don't regret what I've been through, because it makes my faith in God so much stronger. It lets me believe that God is able. And I don't have to stand here and give somebody else's testimony. I don't have to stand here and tell somebody else's story. I can write a volume of books about all my stories. And so I don't regret anything that God has allowed me to go through. In my foolishness, God, there's a scripture somewhat that say the God works the foolishness of man to his wisdom. Though it becomes the wisdom of God. In some kind of way, he allowed us and all of our mix-ups and mess-ups and stumping our toe to become a testimony and become so beautiful when we come to him. And I just thank him for that. I'm so grateful. Glory to God. Even singing a little piece of that song. Let me tell you something. Anybody who worshiped at the last church with me, who was there when I got there? Really, pretty much everybody was there when I got there. Where I used to sit, y'all, all the way in the back on the last row. And the Spirit of God would deal with me so heavily, and I would try to quench it. And one of the ushers one day, she just came and she just say, let it out. And she began to just travail with me. And from that day forward, I was changed. And the Spirit of God spoke to me and said, no longer are you to sit back here. You need to be on the front row. And to me, I was like, I don't want nobody looking at me. I don't want nobody asking me to do nothing. I don't want nobody thinking, sure, she think. That was my mindset. I was always so concerned about what other people thought of me and said about me. And so, but I was obedient and I sat there on the front row. And God began to work in me in such an awesome way. And he began to bring
his purpose for my life to my eyes. And even then, I couldn't believe it. I couldn't believe it for myself. You know, you can see God moving in other people's lives, but you can't realize that gift that God has in you to do some things, to open your mouth and speak, to open your mouth and pray. And this shy and timid way about me, God has really done a work. I mean, you all have been witness to it firsthand. To take the mic and begin to say anything, that's huge for me. To get in front and dance before the Lord is huge for me. To open my mouth and actually sing, I love to sing around the house. But I was in a relationship with a person that was abusive and jealous. And because he had a gift, I guess, to sing, he was all right. He wasn't all that. But everybody pumped him up so much till when I used to sing around the house, he would like turn his nose up and make little comments. And so I thought, wow, I must be really can't sing. I must sound horrible. Let me keep this to myself. But I always loved to sing. And so when the opportunity came at Wholeness to join the praise team, I'm like, okay, I'm going to do it. And so even just to sing the song that you just heard me sing, I know I don't sing the best, but it is all to God's glory. When you hear me open my mouth and sing, when you see me grab the microphone, when you see me do anything in front and out in front, believe it is God's spirit in operation. Because if it was up to me, I would still be sitting even now on the back row on the seat of doing nothing. But God has ignited a fire in me, and I just want to encourage all of us to allow God to ignite that fire in you. The young people I'm talking to y'all today, Christopher, Joya, Tanisha, Markayla, allow God to ignite that fire in you. I have been in, I don't know, I can't even count how many relationships. That's sad. That's not God's way. But in every relationship that I was in that I thought I couldn't do without, I've been addicted to alcohol, like I said. And as good as I thought it made me feel, anything I have ever done in my life does not, it doesn't even begin to compare with the ecstasy, the pure ecstasy that I feel in relationship with my God. I'm compelling you. I am almost getting ready to get on my knees and beg you to allow God to ignite that fire in you. Allow him to do it. If it's anybody in your life, including me, because I get in all y'all face. If it's anybody in your life you need to forgive, forgive them. Today, now, let them go. Anything that has happened in your life, let it go. We all have our stories, we can tell you, I'm sure. Stories of abuse, whether it be the parent, a uncle, a spouse, a boyfriend, girlfriend, mental abuse, physical abuse. We all have our stories. We've been abandoned. We've been mistreated. Sometimes it wasn't even that. It was just the way we perceived it. Amen? Genesis, look at her story. If nobody else inspires you at what she has been through. And when I think of my baby, when she was hooked up to all those tubes and couldn't even help herself, and I couldn't help her, it was God that helped her. And to see the life and the vibrance that's in her, let that be an inspiration to you. I can overcome anything. Look at yourself every morning and say, I'm an overcomer. I am victorious. I'm no longer bound to my past. That is my past. And sometimes we look at young people and we figure, well, what's wrong with them? They don't have no worries. That's not true. They got a lot of pressure on them. They got a lot to deal with in their minds. And they got a lot coming at them when they step on the school grounds. And even in their own room with their own Facebook and social media. There's so much coming at them. And so I just want to encourage us to pray for them. Continue to pray for them. Encourage them. Lift them up. Give them, show them love. Tough love is needed at times. But to show them love. I love all of you. And I want to see you so badly to come up. Tanisha, you got to get in place. The gift of God that is within you. Can I have all y'all just come and stand this way? Let's just begin to intercede for them. I feel it stirring in my belly. Come on, Christopher.
Glory, hallelujah.
It's time to get in place.
Oh, yes. Yes,
because even your very countenance is different.
Yes.
There's a drained look about you. It's because you haven't been in his presence in too long. And you know the gifts that God has given you. And even like we talked about in our last meeting, you say with your mouth, and I really do believe you are grateful to God for all the family he has surrounded you with. But now it's time to show him. Markayla, that gift of leadership that is on you, if your life was to end today and you stood before God and he asked you, what did you do with it? Yeah, you've given some good advice and some good guidance to your friends. But we're called to lead them to Christ. And the way we lead them is by our lifestyle. I've heard so many hypocrites, even up until last night. Nobody's perfect. And it's time for us to pull that down. Those words that lie. As the evangelist just said, God gave us the ability to be perfect. It's just the fact. And I see you where I was. And not knowing, how am I going to do this, God? This is too big for me. I'll do this, and I'm doing. But God wants all of you. And he wants it now. Now is the time. Today is the acceptable day. It's time for you to lead. It's time for you to give all to him. The people that he's moving and causing friction with in your circle is for a reason. Let it be. It's time to sever and be alone for just a little while so God can use you and build you up. You hear from him. The prophetic gift is on you. And it's time to allow that gift to be stirred and used by him. Joya, the prophetic is also resting on you heavily. The visions, the dreams, the very understanding of the word of God that you have in such a deep way. The way you can look upon situations. The spirit of discernment that you have. It's time to allow those gifts to come forth. Allow God to use you. The way you're standing now physically is the way you are in the spirit. Very closed off. And it's time to open your hands and open your arms. And there's time for an exchange. God, I give you all of me and I receive all of you. There's time for an exchange. The Bible says, behold, all things have passed away. The old is now made new. There's a newness that is hovering that is ready. God is ready to pour out onto you. So that you can allow every circumstance and everything that you have been through, every thought, everything, to become a testimony that draws so many. It's time for you to come forth, man of God. It's time for you to come and help me with this dance team. It's time for them gifts to be used. You got a testimony that is so powerful. Not many can overcome addiction. Not many can say, I'm still alive after I've done so much. God has given you so much. You still got health and strength. Look at the opportunity that you have. Do you know the story of Elijah and Elisha? Elijah was a great man of God, and Elisha was one that followed on his skirt tails everywhere that he went, to the point he knew when he was getting ready to die. And they tried to deter him and keep him away. Maybe they thought he couldn't handle it. But he pressed and he said no, because when he dies, I got to receive something from him. And he received Elijah's mantle and he did a double. He received a double portion. You are in a position to receive something so great. You're in the household still with the apostle and the elder, two servants of God. And they are in need of assistance. God is able to continue to do what he's doing through them and to fill the need. But why let another come your inheritance? Don't allow the devil to steal that from you. It's yours. It doesn't matter that you are the younger. You understand that Joseph was the younger. He wasn't supposed to receive anything. But look how God used him to bring his entire family into provision, the provision of God. to actually save his entire family. You are in a great position to save your entire family and to be of aid to this man and woman of God. God rewards that. He rewards the servant's hands. And I pray over your hands this morning. Lift your hands. That these hands are anointed. Glory to God. They are anointed for the work of the Lord in the name of Jesus. These hands are anointed to assist and to hold up. Even as the two men of God held up Moses' hands, oh God, and he began to have victory, hallelujah. We pray and we anoint these hands, hallelujah, for service unto you and you alone, hallelujah, Jesus. Let there even be a burning in these hands, a burning sensation, a tangible way, glory to God. When he chooses to lift these hands or calls him to touch anything that is not of you, glory to God. We pray, God, that you would give him a tangible, physical sign, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Even as you cause your mark to be upon, oh God, God, hallelujah, Cain, and that no one should harm him, Lord God. We pray that you would keep, oh God, put your mark upon him in the name of Jesus, that even when he goes and joins himself and goes into an atmosphere that is not conducive, where you have not led him, where he leads himself, oh God, Father, let him be like a leper unto them, hallelujah. Let them rise up, use them as you use the donkey to prophesy to this man of God and tell him to turn back, hallelujah, and go back to you, that he doesn't belong there, in the name of Jesus. We pray, hallelujah, God, that your anointing, your glory will rest upon him mightily, in the name of Jesus. Teach him today, Lord God, how to worship you, how to serve you. We pray, Lord God, that his heart would be for you and you alone, that every gift that you have given him, Lord God, we come against this way of condemnation. We come against this way that says he's not good enough, that his speech is not good enough. Yeah. Hallelujah. Yeah. We come against that in the name of Jesus. We pull down every lie on that in the name of Jesus. And we pray, hallelujah, that your glory will rest upon him, Lord God. Minister to his mind. Minister to his soul. Hallelujah. That he will receive your truth. Hallelujah. That he is your precious creation. That you have created him. Hallelujah. Wonderfully. Hallelujah. Fearfully made. Hallelujah. That what you have given him, hallelujah, is to be given back to you. Glory to God. That what you have given him, no one else has, oh God. Oh Father, help him to look to you, oh God. Purpose in his heart to serve you, oh God. To give you his best, oh God, in the name of Jesus. We thank you this morning for turning his heart, Lord God. We believe you for it this morning. We believe you, hallelujah, that you are able to do a great work within his heart, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Give him a servant's heart, Lord God. Help him to look and open his eyes and see, Lord God, every need, Lord God. Oh, Father, minister to him, oh God, by making him a servant. Glory to God. We bless you that you say the greatest among us are those who choose to serve. We thank you this morning that he chooses to serve you by serving the man and woman of God. And in this way, you'll bring him into relationship with you, oh God, as he begins to serve selflessly, Lord God. Bring him into relationship with you, God. Oh, Father, show him how you will meet his every need, how you're so willing to meet his every need in the name of Jesus. We thank you, Lord God, and we speak holiness over this soul in the name of Jesus. Every desire, every lustful desire, every way of addiction, oh God, we come against it now in the name of Jesus. We draw a line in the sand over his very soul, and we say, devil, no more in the name of Jesus. We cause him to come out of every trance, oh God, out of every disillusionment, hallelujah, in the name of Jesus. We cause an awareness of God. We cause an awareness of your spirit to come upon his soul, rest upon him mightily in the name of Jesus. We command an urgency to come upon him now and rest upon him in the mighty name of Jesus. We thank you for doing it now, hallelujah. Fill him with your spirit like never before, oh God. Fill him, hallelujah, Jesus. We just thank you for doing it now, oh God. In the name of Jesus we pray. Amen. Hallelujah.
God says pay attention to dreams. There's some answers and some things that you have to give you. He's going to give you those answers in your dreams. Pay attention to the details in your dreams.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Jesus. Glory to God.
time to unwrap and come out of them gray clothes. You got to focus. You got to focus on God. Every other relationship is secondary. And I say this with love. Even the relationship between you and your mother. Every other relationship is secondary to your relationship with Christ. He is the one that has kept you this far. He is the one that has allowed you to prosper as you are. Every other relationship is secondary to your relationship with Christ. If you feel God has called you to be a worship leader, do you feel that God has called you to dance before Him? Then you must not. You cannot. And I speak that you shall not refuse that call. You have to give it your all and allow God to do everything else. This is how we order our day. God, what would you have me to do? The Bible says, seek the kingdom of God and all His righteousness. And then all these other things that you need and that you desire will be added unto you. And it will be done rightly because your heart will be for Him. And He will allow it to come together in His timing and in His way. Amen? It's time. Sometimes we need a little bit of time to regroup and go off a little bit so that when we come back, we're even stronger. The Bible says, now then, there is no condemnation for those that are in Christ Jesus. All of us, every one of us, have strayed. And when we come back, the Father's arms are open. He's waiting for us. He's not in a way of condemning us because we strayed, but He's rejoicing that we have come back. You know the story of the prodigal? The prodigal son? He said, Father, give me my inheritance because I need to go out and live my life. Just give me all what's mine. It was rightfully his, and so his father gave it to him. He went out and he squandered it. He ended up broke within days. And he ended up eating a pig slop. Imagine that. And his father was a rich man living in a palace. And when he came home, the father saw him from afar. How do you think he saw him from afar? He was looking for him. He was waiting for him. Every day he was waiting for him to come back. He saw him from afar. He said, throw a feast. Bring out the best. Bring out the fattened cow. Bring out the best wine. Bring out the best musicians. Everything. My son, who was dead, is returned to me. And that's the way of God. When we return to him, he rejoices, and all heaven rejoices. There is no condemnation. We should never be ashamed or embarrassed when we have gone away and we were returning back. Don't let anybody condemn you for that. Don't let yourself condemn you and keep you away. That's what keeps you away. That's the work of self and the devil. To say, God don't want you back now. You might as well stay out there. The devil is alive. He's waiting for you. The Bible says the shepherd left the 99 who was safe in the fold to go after the one. That's how much he values us. Amen? So it's time to come back. Father God, we just lift up Tanisha, Lord God. And we pray, Lord God, over her very soul, Lord God, that you would order her soul this morning, Lord God. We pray this morning that you would ignite worship in her like never before, oh God. Stir up worship, hallelujah, Jesus. Draw her heart back unto you like never before, God. Draw her into relationship with you that she can proclaim and declare, I love you forever, Lord. You are my Lord. You are my master. Hallelujah. Oh, Father, we pray that the spirit of worship would rest upon her, Lord God. Let your spirit alone wash over her. Let your glory rest upon her mightily, Lord God, in the name of Jesus, that she shall declare your praises, oh God, that she shall do your work, oh God. We pray over this soul, hallelujah, that there would be a resounding yes from her very soul, from her very heart unto you. In the name of Jesus, we pray, oh God, that every spirit of condemnation, every word of accusation from self, the world, the devil, we come against it and we pull it down now in the name of Jesus. We pray that she would enter your marvelous light, hallelujah, in the name of Jesus. We pray that her faith would be ignited in you like never before, that she would believe you to use her mightily, Lord God. We come against this lowly way in the name of Jesus, and we declare her to have the spirit of the warrior, the spirit of a warrior in praise, oh God, a radical praise, a radical worship. We release the prophetic in praise. We release the prophetic in dance in the name of Jesus. Take her to the next level in worship, oh God. Oh, let her experience you like never before. Immerse her, Lord God. Baptize her again in your Holy Spirit, Lord God. Holy Ghost, rest upon her, Lord God. In the name of Jesus, we come against every enemy, every generational curse, every enemy that will try to touch her, Lord God. Every way, hallelujah, of a mother or a father, Lord God, that will try to reach its tentacles and draw her in. We sever it now in the name of Jesus. And we thank you, God, that she is free indeed. We cover her in your blood, oh God. We cover her very body in your blood, her mind, oh God, her heart, oh God. We apply the blood now in Jesus' name. We thank you, Lord God, for a great transformation. We thank you, Lord, and we ask you to ignite your fire in her, Lord God. Ignite your fire in her very belly. Ignite your fire in her heart, Lord God. Father, let her burn for you, Lord God, that she will say it's like fire shut up in my bones. I just can't stop praising. I just can't stop worshiping. I just can't stop talking about it. I just can't stop reading his word. Oh, Father, ignite a passion in her heart like never before, Lord God. A passion to see you, God. A passion to be in relationship with you alone. Father, we come against every soul tied now. Come on, intercede with me, saints. Come on, y'all can do better than that. I need y'all to intercede with me. I'm seeing some things. Come on and intercede with me. We come against every soul tied now in the name of Shiko Rabashataya. Seto Ribashiko Rabashekasata. Come on, you might not know what to pray, but ignite your tongues. The Spirit of God knows that he maketh intercession through you. Yatoko Rebeshasatakaya. Sito Rabashiko Rabita. Shantiko Rabashikara. Oh, hallelujah. We come against every soul tie. Every tie of depression, we sever it now in the spirit, in the name of Jesus. We release the oil of the anointing now. Destroy every yoke, destroy every tie, everything, oh God, that is not like you. Every unholy alliance, oh God, even those which she don't even know about, hallelujah. Even every alliance that she's made with her agreement, the agreement of our lips, the agreement of our participation, we break it now in the name of Jesus. We come against, oh God, every devil, every demon. Devil, you don't have a right to this soul. Take your hands off in the name of Jesus. Take up your weapons and flee from this soul. In the mighty name of Jesus, we sever it now, oh God. We cause it to be destroyed and burned up in the fire of God. In the mighty name of Jesus, we apply the blood. Oh God. Yes, Lord God. Everything that has entered into these ears, everything that has come from her very mouth, oh God, that has caused a curse to come upon her, Lord God, we break the curse. We reverse it now in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Oh, we apply
by your blood over this soul, over this mouth, over these ears, over these eyes. We declare holiness, oh God, in the name of Jesus. We declare that she shall not stray from this day. Hallelujah, God. We declare and decree that her desire is to serve you. Her desire is to please you and you alone. We declare and decree in our life that you are first and foremost, oh God. No one and nothing is more important than you, not even herself, oh God. We declare and we decree it over her life, oh God, that there would never be a turning back, oh God. She would never be the same from this day forward, oh God. We thank you and we declare her liberty. We declare her freedom in you, oh God. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name.
Peculiar people, chosen generation, royal priesthood. You're not fit. So don't put the energy into fitting in. Put your energy into seeking and serving Him. And He will show you, doing you things that you cannot imagine. So focus your people.
Glory to God. Come on and join us, ladies. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Yes, Lord. Jesus. Anytime your mouth is shut, I'm in the company of the saints.
Yes.
Hallelujah!
Amen.
By grace.
Yes.
You need to get breakthrough. All you need is to break through.
I have a question.
Like I told you that before. You need to break. You need to open your mouth. Like you talk to us. When we all just have a good FF. You need to do that in the company of the saints. You need to release yourself now. That when you go home, you'll be able to say, you know, Lord, I just thank you. You don't have to say it out loud. Lord, I just thank you. But your deliverance is here.
That's right.
This is where you're going to get it. You got to open your mouth and say, thank you, Jesus. Yes. Hallelujah. Come on, y'all.
Yes.
Come on.
Y'all let's give them praise. Hallelujah.
Y'all
all
that shame. That's the way y'all act around.
Come on.
Let's open
our mouth. We're going to do it with you.
Yeah.
Come on, let's
just
praise.
Yeah.
Let's open our mouth.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Waiting.
Yes,
Lord.
You're not waiting.
That's right.
God said, I'm waiting. I'm waiting for you to just release yourself in my praise, in my worship, in my glory, because I love you so much. You know he loves you. Now the prophet is just ministering a word, a fresh oil, because God is constantly pouring out. And like Evangelist said, don't fit in. Amen. Praise the Lord, young lady.
The additional word is the fact that your life is hid in Christ. I don't care what you accomplish, how many degrees, how much money, how many houses. It does not matter. He has the answer, the ultimate answer for your life. And it's important at your age that you figure that out now. You have people around to help you, to support you, in seeking Him and having and understanding. Your life is hid in Christ. You're not going to be all of what you could be unless and until you surrender to Him 100% fully. He will do things and take you places, cause favor, open doors that you cannot even imagine. But it is when you surrender to Him 100%. Everything that is within you, your capabilities, He will even basically give you gifts that you didn't even know existed. He has the answer. He has the key. And again, at your ages, it's very important that you understand that and lock into it. I think you'll save yourself from wasting a lot of time.
Oh,
amen.
Take it from those of us who know.
Amen.
You
will save yourself from wasting a lot of time.
Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
I just want to read this scripture into our hearing.
Yes.
Romans, the 6th chapter in its entirety.
Glory to God.
I'm reading from the New Living Translation. Amen. Romans 6.
Glory to God. Amen.
Praise the Lord. God is so good.
Yes, He is.
Romans, the 6th chapter, and it reads, well then, should we keep on sinning so that God can show us more and more of His wonderful grace? Of course not. Since we have died to sin, how can we continue to live in it? Or have you forgotten that when you were joined with Christ Jesus in baptism, we joined Him in His death? For we died and were buried with Christ by baptism. And just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glorious power of the Father, now we also may live new lives. Somebody say new lives.
New lives.
Since we have been united with Him in His death, we will also be raised to life as He was. We know that our old sinful selves were crucified with Christ so that sin might lose its power in our lives. We are no longer slaves to sin. For when we died with Christ, we were set free from the power of sin. And since we died with Christ, we know we will also live with Him. We are sure of this because Christ was raised from the dead. And He will never die again. Death no longer has any power over Him. When He died once to break the power of sin. But now that He lives for the glory of God. So you also should consider yourselves to be dead to the power of sin and alive to God through Christ Jesus. Do not let sin control the way you live. Do not give in to sinful desires.
Yes.
Do not let any part of your body become an instrument of evil to serve sin. Instead, give yourselves completely to God. For you were dead, but now you have new life. Somebody say new life.
New life.
So use your whole body as an instrument to do what is right for the glory of God.
Sin is no longer your master. Sin is no longer your master. Sin is no longer your master. For you no longer live under the requirements of the law. Instead, you live under the freedom of God's grace. Well then, since God's grace has set us free from the law, does that mean we can go on sinning? Of course not. Don't you realize that you become the slave of whatever you choose to obey? You can be a slave to sin, which leads to death. It's your choice. Or you can choose to obey God, which leads to righteous living. Thank God. Once you were slaves of sin, but now you wholeheartedly obey this teaching we have given you. Now you are free from your slavery to sin, and you have become slaves to righteous living. Because of the weakness of your human nature, I am using the illustration of slavery to help you understand all this. Previously, you let yourselves be slaves to impurity and lawlessness, which led ever deeper into sin. Now you must give yourselves to be slaves to righteous living so that you will become holy. Jesus. When you were slaves to sin, you were free from the obligation to do right. And what was the result? You are now ashamed of the things you used to do. Right? Things that end in eternal doom. But now you are free from the power of sin and have become slaves of God. Now you do those things that lead to holiness and result in eternal life. For the wages of sin is death, but the free gift of God is eternal life through Christ Jesus our Lord. Hallelujah. 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 But I'm a slave. My God. Hallelujah. God bless you.
Preach right off that. I'm free, but I'm a slave to God. Hallelujah. Anybody want to piggyback after that? Hallelujah. Glory to God. I tell you to grab this mic. Hallelujah. How many enjoying themselves in the word of God up under the heavens? Amen. You need to know today that you are free to live and be to soar as high as you want to be in God. Isn't it good to know that you are no longer a mere man? That the power and the authority and the dominion that God has given you is yours. You got to take the ownership of your salvation personally. That this belongs to me and I'm not giving it up for an occasion of self. I'm not giving it up for an occasion of a light getting high or a light addiction or a light affliction. Because sometimes our affliction is sin. Many times affliction is sin. Glory to God. But when we know who we are, glory to God, we can soar in God, knowing that in Him we live and move and we have our being, and apart from Him, we can't do anything. How many know that you, in Christ, you are the unstoppable enablement of God in the earth? And just the same miracles, signs, and wonders, the work that Christ did in the earth, so are you. Say with me, I'm anointed. I'm appointed. I'm called by God. You got to know who you are. It's time for the body of Christ to draw the line in the sand and say, no longer self is having me. No longer the world is going to tell me what to do. No longer self is going to tell me what to do. I belong to God. I am His slave. He is my Adonai. He's my Lord. He is the master of my soul. My agenda and everything about me is in His hand. You know, it's such a wonderful experience to be an infant. Infant don't worry about anything, glory to God. All the infant do is drink, eat, and poop.
That's right.
And release. Drink, eat, glory to God, eat, sleep, and release. Glory to God. And it's so wonderful that all that child does is wait for the mother to carry them everywhere they go. This is how it is when you are in Christ. We got to shake ourselves from living this hard life always struggling. You should not be struggling as a child of God. It ain't, say with me, struggling ain't pretty. And it sure ain't Bible. But the Bible does say the sinful nature wrestles against the flesh and the flesh against the spirit. These two go against each other. You know why? Because the man forget what manner of man he is. No longer you are a man of sin. You are a man of the negativity, the rudiments, and the begging and the lowliness of this world. You are no longer, Paul say that, you are called out of darkness. This is no longer you. You got to see yourself where God sees you. Now I am a son of light. I am a son of God. I am the priest of God. I'm no longer what I used to be. I am a new creature in Christ. All things are passed away. I am new. Therefore, I am enabled to prophesy and speak and call those things that be not as though they were. Hallelujah. This is the confidence we have in him, that if we ask, if we speak, if we ask anything according to his will, he heareth us. Say with me, God, hear me. When I pray, I belong to him. I'm in Christ. I'm in God. Nevertheless, I live, but not me, but Christ lives in me. I am his dependent. I am his protege. I am his child. He is my Lord. He is my provisionary. Did you know everything you need is in God? It is not your job that's taking care of you. It is not the provision of the government that is taking care of you. It is not your neighbor. It is not your parents that is taking care of you. You got to see God greater than you're looking around horizontally to these counterfeit things that we think that are taking care of us. This is why God told us to look up your redemption, your hope, your help, all that you need. It draws nigh. As you draw nigh to him, he said, I'll draw nigh to you. But you can't draw nigh to God. As the book of Romans talk about, you are no longer a slave to sin. When you draw nigh to him, you can't draw nigh to him in your way. You got to draw nigh to him with his stuff. Using the power that's invested in you. Say with me, I'm anointed. I'm called. God has so much for me. So much greater than I can even imagine. I am a minister of reconciliation. I'm called by God to win the lost. I'm called by God to open the eyes of the blind, to lay hands on the sick, and they will, they shall, they recover. I'm called by God to speak, to cause demons to be released out of the atmosphere. The Bible says one can chase 1,000, two can chase 10,000. Glory to God. When you walk in your home, you walk on your job, when you walk in the marketplace, wherever you are, you are always inactive, but you're always active. You're never, say with me, I'm never inactive. I'm always active. See, one thing about a warrior, a soldier, who knows who they are, they're always active. They're never inactive. They're even on vacation. They're always ready to fight, ready to be on the offense and the defense. You are on the offense, meaning you are offending everything that's not like God. So when may I offend the devil? I want to make him mad. You don't never want the devil to like you. He's your greatest hater. And the people he uses is your greatest hater. But what? You are God's greatest lover. Why? You are enabled to love those that despitefully use you. This is the defense that God has given you. You defend his righteous cause. First you offense, and then you defend his righteous cause in you. I defend love by what? Being love.
That's right.
I can't shipwreck my moment. Hallelujah. I'm going to close out reading Ephesians 5:15. This is a scripture that we always should remember. Seven things that God wants us to do. Amen. Let's read these seven things right quick, and then we're going to look, glory to God, prophetess, and come back. Hallelujah. And if anybody is under the skies this morning, if you would like prayer, glory to God, the altar is always open. It is never closed. But if you desire prayer for whatever reason, after we read Ephesians 5, you can come and we'll go up in intercession. We're always ready to go up in intercession at any moment. Intercession on the behalf of the people of God never stops. Amen. For some reason, my little Bible app won't just act up. Oh, let me go to another app that I... Okay. Ephesians 5, 15. These are seven things that God wants us to do. And you need to remember these seven things. Allow these seven things to be branded in your soul. These seven things are rhema. They are logos, meaning they are alive. I'm trying to find them in the New Living. Yours is the ASV. I have it right. Yeah. Thank you, Tom. Thank you. If you really let these seven things that God wants you to do to really permeate your thinking and to bring your soul, you will see yourself as an unstoppable tool in the hand of the Lord, meaning nothing by any means can shipwreck who you are in God and your purpose that He has called you to do. These are the seven things. 15th verse of Ephesians 5. So be careful how you live. These are the instructions of the Lord. Don't live like fools, but live like those who are wise. Make the most of every opportunity in these evil days. And you know, when you're making the most opportunity of every opportunity in these evil days, God is saying, I want you to make the most of every opportunity to bring glory to me. I've called you. You are mine. I bought you with a price. And so because you are mine, I want to maximize myself in you. I've invested myself, my gifts, my spirit, and all my anointing to destroy every yoke. Nothing should hinder you. So because I've given you all this power, I've given you this power so you can affect the world. Make the most of every opportunity. 17 verse 8, don't act thoughtlessly. Thoughtless people do anything. They are tay in the wind. I made that word up. Tay means their mind just out there. You won't find that word in the dictionary. I'm on dictionary, y'all ain't know. Tay in the wind, meaning their mind is just wandering and whatever comes their way. Hey, Sarah. Whatever would be, okay, that's what we're doing, okay, that's what I'm going to do. Don't act thoughtless. Don't think thoughtless, meaning when the enemy comes and brings stuff, I ain't planning to do that today. Learn the gift of no. I'm practicing and I'm learning the gift of no in this season of my life on another level. And I mean when it comes down to getting my weight down and getting my blood pressure down and saying no to some things that I just like. It's not that it's sin, it's just, I just need to say no. I need to show myself, I need to prove it to me that I got control, that I'm using the power that God has invested in me. So I examine myself by putting myself through the challenge. And so if I think thoughtless, I'm going to shipwreck what I started. You begin well, you begin on this process, on this journey. to reach your goal, but what hinder you? Being thoughtless. Thoughtless minds allow anything to come and get you off your mark. Set your goals and stay there. Set your standard. I'm not having this. I'm not dealing with that anymore. I'm going to lose weight. I'm not getting into another relationship. I'm not dealing with any more bumbles. I'm not dealing with any jobs that, any jobs that's really, say what you want. I don't want to work at Burger King or McDonald's. I want to work, this is what I want. And because this is what I want, I'm not going to think thoughtless and think I ain't got to do my due diligence to get what I want. I want to be healthy. I want the things that I need for this season in life. But I can't be thoughtless. Say it with me, I can't be thoughtless. I ain't got time for being thoughtless in my daily doings. Then it says, but understand what the Lord wants you to do. This is what he wants you to do. All the way back to the 15th verse. Be careful how you live. Don't live what like food. Be wise. This is what understanding. I need to understand with all my understanding, with all my knowledge, I need to get an understanding. This is where wisdom comes into play. We got a lot of knowledge, but we got no understanding. Understanding is just like wisdom, which is going to tell us how to use the knowledge we know. We can't know some things that don't know how to put it into action. We got to put it into action where it's going to be beneficial to us. Then the 18th verse say, don't be drunk with wine. And he's talking about real wine right here. Say it with me, he's talking about real wine. That will ruin your life. Real wine will ruin you. Yes, it will. And being drunk also, there's a spiritual drunkenness, which is the same as spiritual adultery. Letting everything come before God. Your husband come before God. Your children come before God. Your money come before God. Your job come before God. You come before God. Everything come. You're drunk. Nothing comes before God. Nothing. Nobody. Not even your spouse. Amen. So don't get so drunk and so, oh, I'm so in love. Oh, I'm so busy with my business. I'm so busy with my stuff. You know, God, I would witness. I would obey the call that you're calling me to. But you know what? You're drunk. He said drunkenness, spiritual drunkenness. Just like physical drunkenness will ruin you, spiritual drunkenness will ruin you spiritually. Instead, he said, be filled with the Spirit. Say with me, I must be filled with the Spirit. Daily he loads us with benefits of being filled, the benefit to come before the throne of grace. That's a benefit, to obtain the mercy, to obtain the favor that you need, to obtain the passion and the refilling of God. Daily you can go before him. He said, be filled with the Spirit. And when we're filled with the Spirit, you can sing songs and hymns and spiritual songs and melody in the assembly, making music like we did today. We sung. If you wanted to sing a solo, you can still sing a solo. If you want to sing, if you got a word of wisdom you want to give in the company of the saints, by all means. This is what the assembling of yourselves bring us to. Glory to God. This is our time to express ourselves. That when we go, charity starts in the house of God. When we go outside of the house of God, we maintain status quo. We still know how to operate in our gifts. He said, make melody in your hearts to the Lord, and give thanks. Lastly, give thanks for everything to God the Father in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Make Ephesians 5:15 on down to around the 20th verse. Make that one of your scripture that you visit a lot and that you refresh yourself and say, I'm being careful, spiritually careful. The Bible said for us to watch and pray. He means to watch physically and to watch spiritually. And I like to keep saying this. Many people are dead in the grave because they didn't watch physically. We're living in a world where men are coming up on men and because they're caught up. Caught up, they come up on you and rob you. Many people have been kidnapped because they're so into where they, oh, I got a shot. Oh, what else I need? No, you better watch what's around you. You come out of the storm watching and praying. Yeah. You got to get you a taser, get you a taser. If you need to touch somebody, I'll touch them in love after I touch them and get them off of me. Get off of me, devil. We got to wake ourselves. The Bible tells us to be wise as serpent, yet harmless as a dove. It's time for the enemy to stop robbing the church and coming up on us, surprising us, thieving, stealing and robbing and breaking in our homes and things. Wake up. The devil shouldn't be robbing and stealing and nothing you got. Why? Because the God that you serve, El Roi, see everything. Say with me, if God see it, I see it. Because he going to tell me. So you want your ears open to hear what the Spirit is saying. So when you get drunk and caught up, you can't hear the Spirit. You hear other stuff. Amen. Glory to God. Anybody need prayer on this morning? Glory to God. Hallelujah. Come on up for prayer. Those that need prayer, prophetess, come on up. Glory to God. And let's intercede. While we're praying for those that are coming up, glory to God, somebody can run to the church and get the hot dogs on the second row, and then the oranges. You see two bags you need to grab out of your refrigerator so we can begin to have our little fellowship or refreshment after the service. Amen. Evangelist, can you bring the water? Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory to God. This bottle of water is anointed, and the oil of the Lord is upon it. Glory to God. Hallelujah, Jesus. As we pray, we're going to intercede. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You know, God is meeting your needs right now. There's such an anointing that is resting and waiting to pour out. God is pouring out upon the church at large. There is such a provision of God. Do you feel it? There's such a provision. It is just waiting to be released. And that's all you got to do. Just open up and just receive the provision of God. God said, I'm meeting your needs right now. I need somebody to come and stand behind her. Come over here. God said, I'm meeting your needs right now. I am meeting your needs. I see you. And I see you when you sleep. I see you when you arise. I see you when you're up and when you're down. I see you when you speak. I see you when you're worried. But my angels are right there around you. They are holding you up. They are lifting you up. My angels are in camp around about you. I love you. There's such a love that I have. And I want you to receive it today. Receive the love of God. We come against the enemy that would hinder this servant from receiving the love from God. We rebuke every foul devil, every enemy of her soul, every demonic influence of the Moshakaya. We pull it down right now to the Mokoya. We release every addiction, enemy. You can't, devil, you can't have this woman of God. You can't have this servant. We call her life sealed and signed for God's use alone. Oh, Shabbatiah, we release every spirit of hell from that assignment. We see you, devil. We bind you. We quandary you in every way. Oh, Shabbatiah, let God arise around this servant and every enemy be scattered. Be scattered, devil. Oh, Shabbatiah, we receive the love of God. We receive the provision of God. We receive the protection of God. We receive the kingdom of God. We receive the healing of God. Healing is the children born. We call this body to be healed, hold, delivered, set free, one with God, one with Christ. I hear God say, he's changing your desires, those desires, and he's giving you wisdom. God say, I'm giving you wisdom for living, wisdom that's going to cause your total life to change. And you know what that wisdom means? What to eat, what to put in your body, wisdom to begin to start exercising, wisdom all the way down to what clothes you put on. God said, I'm giving you wisdom, my daughter. I love you so much. I'm giving you wisdom. Father, I pray that her ears will be open. Open, 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 open to hear wisdom. Open to hear wisdom. Open, and we declare that nothing will hinder these ears from hearing the voice of God and obeying the Lord Most High. We release the wisdom of God to rest and rule and abide. And abide. God said, I'm meeting your needs. My provision is right there for you. He said, I am your God. I am your daddy. I am the lover of your soul. I am your husband. Marry me, said God. God said, will you marry me? He said, would you marry me? God said, I'm calling you into intimacy. Where you begin to tell him in the quietness of your day and your evening, Lord, I just love you. Lord, I just serve you. I just want you. I need you. Glory to God. Just begin to love on him. He changes your whole outlook. The people that once say they know you, they'll never know you in this way. Unless they're in the spirit. God is building you in a fresh way. Glory to God. Amen, 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 amen. Hallelujah. We command every enemy that were possibly trying to hinder you to loose you. The Lord told me to come and see you. And I'm going to come to your house and I'm going to visit you. I haven't come yet, but I'm going to come and I'm going to visit you. And we're just going to sit down and we're going to talk. We're just going to talk because God loves you so much. He loves you. And the things that you think you can't have, God said you can have them. God said, I'm getting ready to give you the things that you think you need my way. I'm going to give it to you my way. And when he give it to, when he do it his way, it's going to be all right. God said, everything that is crooked and not right, that frustrates you, because there's some things that bother you. There's some things that's bothering you. Jesus, I feel it. I feel it. There's some things that are bothering you. And I feel it. God say, I'm making them straight. God say, I'm straightening them. Come on, come on. God say, I'm straightening. I'm straightening. God say, the things that are bothering, there's some things that are really getting to you. I feel that in my belly. But you know what? He said, I'm coming to make those crooked places straight. That you will begin to soar. God said, I see you. And I am with you more than you know. And then I promise not to leave you. And I will never forsake you. And I love you more than anything. This is God speaking to you. He said, I'm going to show you my hand. I'm going to show you my hand. Glory to God. I'm going to show you my hand. And when you see me in this way, this will be a way that you've never seen me before. God say, I'm getting ready to show you my face. I'm showing you my face. Pull up, I'm showing you. Do it, Holy Ghost. Do it, Holy Ghost. We release the angel of the Lord to encamp around your daughter, God. Meet all her needs according to your riches and glory. Oh God, let your blood, oh God, let your oil of Oshayah again. Oh, hallelujah. You promise that the yoke shall be removed from around the neck and it shall be destroyed because of the oil. We thank you for the oil. God said, I got more than enough oil to carry you and your whole household, your children, your grandchildren. God said, I got more than enough oil to cover you. He said, I'm not a God of separation, but I'm a God of unity my way. My God. I'm a God of unity, glory to God. And God said, when you see his hand, you're going to say, wow, look at God. Look what the Lord has done. And it's going to be all his doing, amen? Even on your job, God said he's going to release you on Sunday mornings when you get in the church. Anytime you get ready, he's getting ready to release you. He's getting ready to release you, right? You know what? God said your words, what you say, speak what you say. Don't be afraid. Stop being intimidated. Don't be intimidated. Seriously. Don't be intimidated. What you feel in your heart and what he's giving you, the desire in your belly, what you want to do for him, don't be intimidated. Say what you want. Speak it. Don't be afraid. Well, you know what? If I say this, then they might. God said, there is no word when it comes down to man. Speak what you desire and watch God move for you. Amen. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Jesus. Glory to God. Now here God said, bought with a price. Yeah, you are mine, bought with a price. You know when you go in the store and you buy something, and when you got ownership of, say you go in the store and you buy a person, you got ownership of that person. It belongs to you, right? And you take it home with you. And you're not going to lie to anybody to just come and take what belongs. Why? Because you bought it. God say, I bought you. I bought you with a price. And there was no devil, no enemy, no words that's been spoken against you, no hate, no strife, nothing, no self, no sin, no world, no devil can separate you from my love. You are bought with a price. And God said, I'm setting you up right now as we speak. I'm calling your feet to be stabled in him. God said, I'm putting you on a solid foundation, which is in Christ. It is the rock, glory to God. He is the rock. You are the church of the living God, standing on the rock, which is Christ. And God said, I'm establishing you. Fear not. Fear not. Don't be afraid, because I am with you. Doesn't matter who will go with you and who won't go with you. God said, I am with you. Trust me. Trust me. God said, seek his face like never before. God is transitioning you. I don't know if it's on your job or where you live. Glory to God. I don't know. Hallelujah. I don't know about relationship, but there's a transition going on. God said, I'm moving you from where you are to. Anytime God moves us from where we are, it's just like taking a step. Say your goal is to get to Minister Michelle. And the closer you get, glory to God, you get closer to what you planning on getting to. God said, when I'm transitioning you, the closer you get to your destination, then I'm going to begin to reveal. That means you're going to be enabled to see where he's taking you. See, some things look like some things are a diamond in the rough. And sometimes it looks like, you know, it ain't pretty.
Yes.
And it's not appealing. Okay. That's the way our Lord was. Salvation is not appealing to many, glory to God. Because many don't understand the scripture and the beauty of holiness and what God is saying. But God said this transitioning is not appealing. And so it looks like it might not be the right way to go. But God said the closer you get, glory to God, and the fire of the passion of God will begin to intensify. I don't know where this transition it is. He has not told me. But it's just like a diamond, glory to God. They say when a diamond is first, when it comes from the rock, it doesn't look appealing. But as the fire hits it, it begins to, the beauty of that diamond begin to come to fruition. Meaning it begin to come to manifestation where you can know, wow, that is a diamond. You know how some worlds you've taken in life, and you said, dang, I ain't want to go over here, but, oh, I ain't want to do that, but golly, I ain't realized that was going to bring me this. God said, I bring you to this to give you that. Glory to God, that's how he set you up. And I don't know if you have any special requests this morning, glory to God. You just want a general prayer, glory to God. covering over your life, but God said he's changing your heart, and he's causing you to be solid in him, and he's going to cause the gifts of God to come out of you. You've been too dormant. I don't even know you. Don't even know where you come from. This is my first time ever seeing you. But God said the gift of God, this is time for it to come out of you. It's time for you to move in God. Glory to God. Where's that water? We put glory to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Father, in this great transition, in this place of moving, oh God, as you lead your daughter, Lord God, oh hallelujah, I pray that her ears will be wide open to hear what the Spirit has to say to the church. For your word's sake, glory to God, that your sheep hear your voice. And so we come against any enemy of the word, any enemy of your servant that would try and hinder her from hearing your voice, any enemy that would try to bring a smoke screen to cloud her eyes, her eyesight, her memory, her vision. We rebuke it right now. We quandar the enemy that would kinder her the vision of the Lord. Oh Father, we pray that she will be, oh hallelujah, ever so connected to you, Lord God, that she will be like Peter. Though I know there's water here and there's a storm here, but I'm going to walk out on God. I'm going to believe God calls faith, oh God, to move her into your very agenda, Lord God. Oh Father, we thank you, Lord God, that this transition, oh God, though it may not be popular, it may not be pretty, it may not be appealing, but God, we come against the spirit of fear, but you have not given her fear. Oh, Shekinah, we command fear, we adjure it to come over her heart. Shekinah, we declare that this heart of our Shekinah shall be strong in the Lord. We come against infirmity, every fear, every disease that the enemy will try to infiltrate this woman of God. We come against heart disease. We come against high diabetes and high blood pressure. We release you now. We command you, in this transition of great healing. We thank you, Lord God, that she will become one with you. And we drive at the enemy. We break every generational curse from her childhood. We destroy it by the blood. The blood of the Lamb, Shekiah, the Lord. Oh, Shekiah, the higher. We call for legions of angels to safely remove her, Lord of Ashiah, from the premises of her past into your greatness, oh God, into your glory, Lord of Ashiah, into a total 360 transformation where you are glorified, oh Lord. We call her healed. We call her sane. We call her whole. And we call for your sevenfold spirit. The spirit of the Lord. Spirit of wisdom. Spirit of understanding. Spirit of might. Spirit of knowledge. The spirit of the fear of the Lord. We release it to the Lord. Shakaya. Shakaya. I hear God say, my sevenfold spirit will begin to minister literally to you. And your ears will be open. We declare that over you. That you will hear. When the spirit of might moves, you'll move with them. When the spirit of understanding moves, you'll move with them. When the spirit of the Lord moves, you'll move with them. When the spirit of the fear of the Lord moves, you'll move with him. Man, let me tell you something. Hallelujah. There's a great transition. And I didn't know where God was taking that. But when God does a transition upon the body of Christ, actually, there's a great transition. Praying for you is like praying for the body. Actually, there is a great transition of the entire body.
body of Christ. If we can get it, then we got it. And we can run with it. You know what God say? I'm just looking for a few people that are crazy enough to hear my voice, to take this oil of wholeness to the nation. I'm just looking for a few good folk that gonna take the truth and take along with the spirit of wisdom, the spirit of the Lord, and all these spiritual giftings that he has given us. God say, I'm meeting your provision, even physically, tangibly. I'm meeting your needs. Open your ears. Hear my instruction. I'm going to tell you what to do, because some things I'm going to tell you to pull back on. And I'm going to say, no, daughter. Some things I'm going to tell you, God said he's going to tell you. And you're going to hear him. You probably already heard him. And God said, as you obey his voice and walk it out, you're going to bring a lineage behind you. Anytime God brings you out, there's a deliverer, and the deliverer is the Holy Ghost. When God brought the children of Israel out, he didn't bring out just a few folk. He brought out millions of them. When you come out of anything, you got a nation that's coming out behind you. It's the great influence that comes from the great commission of God. It's attached to it. You feel that? Oh, there is power in the name of Jesus. There is power in Jesus.
When did she first bought those?
Wow.
And she
walked
forward.
Wow. Break every, you see, and that's what led you here. Okay, break every chain. To break every chain. This is your song. Break every chain. Break every chain. There's an army rising. You are part of that army. There's an army rising. There's an army rising up. To do what? To break every chain. To break every chain. To break every chain. And you know what? As you go about your daily doing, just agree with the Lord. Because the Lord prophetically gave that song to our sister. And you tell the Lord, I hear the chains falling. As you go through your daily life, I hear them falling, God. Anything that you are believing God for, I hear it falling against, away from me. Anything that's coming, I hear it falling. As it falls, you will begin to come forth. You'll begin to come forth, amen.
Georgia. I'm a Georgia girl.
So I appreciate you. Where you moved in? I moved here a month ago. Oh my God! That's a great deal. Yeah. Wow. You're so fresh in the earth, in the area. So you're looking for a church home, huh? Amen. Well, just in case you are, we're right down the street. Amen. We're down this street. Our building is right down here. On Fifth Sundays, we worship under the skies. Amen. Hallelujah. 10 a.m. on Sunday morning. We'll show you where we are. Hallelujah. You coming for prayer? What you doing? Walking through you? You walking through the park? I hear God. I saw you earlier. I told you, come on over here. You know what God said? I heard God say, you just walked into life. Life is calling you. So that death can no longer hold you. I hear God. He said, life is calling you so that death will no longer hold you in bondage. And I'm going to make it plain so you can understand. Amen. What I mean by death spiritually, we all are spirits like God is. We have a body. We're a three-part being. And we have a soul, which is our mind, our thinking. But when we die, we're not finished. Just the body goes to the grave. But our soul and our spirit go back to God. Then we go before God to be judged at the great white throne judgment, the Bible calls it. And as the Lord judges, He determines whether we will spend eternity with Him in heaven or whether we will end up in hell. But I hear God say, life is calling you. You just walked up onto life. And so the invitation is that you have to receive life in order to partake of it. If you were thirsty and you wanted water, you say, I'm choking, ma'am. Give me some water. And if that water you needed to stay alive, and you say, no, I don't want to drink it, you die, right? But when you drink the water, you're refreshed. Your esophagus and everything opens up so you can breathe. Amen. This is the way salvation is. Knowing Christ, the Savior, the one who died for you. The Bible says from the foundation of the world, He was slain just for you. You've heard the story of the virgin birth of Jesus. You know about the resurrection, which is Easter is coming. He rose for you. He's calling you. He's calling you. The word that you heard is an invitation that you need to answer. Will you answer? God is calling you into the house of the Lord. It's time for you to start going to church. It's time for you to start connecting to the church. You see all these men? We got six men, I think, a part of our... I don't know if all six of them are out here. But He's calling you into the house of the Lord. Will you answer the invitation? Will you answer? Do you live in this neighborhood? If I hear God... He said, we came in here, out here today to bring you life. I don't know why I keep hearing Him say that. Will you receive the invitation? Will you make the declaration with your own mouth? I'm not telling you to do something today and tomorrow we can't find you. I'm talking about you make it today and you connect with the people of God so that you can learn the word of God. These men and him got some great testimony. Elder back there, they got powerful testimonies. I know you die! God is calling you and there's a gift in your belly. You musical? After we finish, I want you to talk to Prophet. Just let him tell you his testimony. When he made that transition to come into God, even Minister Carl and my husband right there. He's calling you out of a lifestyle of wayward, being out there into the house. You ready to be planted in church? When you show up on Sunday, you miss it. When you show up on Monday for Bible study, and if you, how far do you live? Where do you live?
Right
now. Come home. Oh, so Prophet been, well, the church is right. He's calling you. So I want you to just receive Him today. Come back to Him today. And we're going to cover you in prayer. And we're going to be a team right around you. And we're going to watch God transform your life. I watch God transform
many other people that's standing right under this brick pavilion, and they watch God transform my life the same. Amen. Just repeat after me. Say, dear Lord Jesus, I ask that you forgive me of my sins. Lord, I'm sorry. Make me broken over my sin. Break my heart for what breaks yours. I believe that Jesus Christ died on the cross for my sin. And on the third day, he rose again. Because he lived, I can live also. Thank you, Lord, for saving me. Thank you, Lord, for filling me with your Holy Spirit. Lift your hands and ask the Holy Spirit, Holy Spirit, what am I wanting? Holy Spirit, fill me. Holy Spirit, fill me from the crown of my head to the sole of my feet. Fill me, Holy Ghost. I want to feel your oil. I want to feel your anointing. I want to feel your deliverance. Hallelujah. We come against every enemy of this young man's soul. We serve the devil. Notice today, in the name of Jesus, we rebuke every addiction, every stronghold, every assignment that comes from the enemy that would so easily keep him from coming in the house of the Lord. We rebuke it now in the mighty name of Jesus. We render every weapon of the enemy useless against him. We quadrate it. Everything, every robber, we come against self. Even self may tell him, you don't have to go to church. You don't have to do anything. We rebuke it now. And we call his life to the glory and honor of God alone. Oh, Shebabakaya. We serve every addiction, every kindred foe, every wayward spirit, every obstinate spirit, every rebellious spirit, everything that's not like God. We resist it. And we render it useless against this young man. And we call him back to the fold. We call him back to the fold. We call him under your great word. We call him under your great oil of deliverance. We call him under your understanding. We release your sevenfold spirits upon his life. The spirit of wisdom, spirit of might, the spirit of the Lord, the spirit of fear, the fear of the Lord, the spirit of peace, and the spirit of joy, and all the spirit of the Lord. We release it right now. Rest upon him now, God. Spirit of knowledge, rest. Speak to his soul, God. Rest every enemy. Every word, every lie that's been sold against this mind. Oh, we separate every lie, every error, every self-righteous way, every thief, we rebuke it. Hashanakaya. We pull every thought down, every high thought that exalt itself against the knowledge of God that already has been stolen in this mind. We pull it down against it, and we call forth wholeness. We call forth the mind of Christ. We declare that he will let this mind that was in Christ also be in him. Let there be a hunger and thirst. Oh Shababakaya, I feel that. Let there be a hunger and a thirst for righteousness. And we declare that he shall be fed. We call you planted in the house of the Lord, where you are able to flourish in the courts of our God. It's time out for people to look at the things of God in the wrong way. But you got to get it in the right way, according to the way God sees it. And the way God sees it, as you're planted in the house of the Lord and you hear the word of God, this is what changes your mind. This is what calls this mind of Christ to be in you. Christ purified his church by the washing of his very word, which is life.
The words I speak, Christ say, they are life. And they'll be life upon your soul. They are spirit. Meaning the word of God is alive. It's powerful. And everything you need, the word will bring the very provision of God right to you. Amen. But you got to submit your whole self. So now you belong to God. Amen. You want to make us your church family? Because I'm not going to let you go without offering that invitation. All right. Glory to God. Welcome home. Come on, one at a time. Come on and welcome home. What's your first name, young man?
Romel.
Let's welcome Romel home in the house of the Lord. And I believe Prophet Proverbs would even just ride you down now, so just show you, just so you can get to see the church. Amen. So it's the glory to God. Sister Black, you're coming for prayer. Amen. Welcome. Come on, give him a welcome. Romel, we welcome you. Amen. We welcome you into the house of the Lord. They that are planted in the house of the Lord, we declare that you shall flourish in the house of your God. Amen. Glory to God. What's your first name, sweetheart? Demetrius? Cometrius. Okay. You know the invitation is open to you too. If you want to make us your church home, just tell me. Say, yeah, Pastor. We're right down the road. Well, you right in the neighborhood though. We'll give you an invitation. Glory to God. How you doing, Sister Brown? You ain't getting the memo. Where your jeans at? You supposed to have on jeans and t-shirts. Oh, you went to the church and saw the sign on the door? No. It wouldn't feel Sunday. Where is he? Tell him to come. Oh, it's too much wind. Oh. Well, we so glad that he did come. I will. Y'all gonna hang around a little bit because we gonna grill hot dogs and have some chips and a little sweets. So just hang out a little bit. Father, we just lift up your daughter, Lord. We thank you, Lord God, for bringing her, Lord God, safely back in the company of the saints, oh God. Father, we thank you that your favor is resting upon her, and you're moving her closely, closely to you, Lord God, close to your heart, close to your throne room. And we thank you for Tony being here today, Father. We thank you for your anointing, the all of healing that is resting upon his very body. Even now, we thank you, Lord God, for calling him to be risen up in strength and healing, oh God. We thank you, Lord God, that you have not called him to death. You have not called him to this enemy of cancer, but you called him to healing. And so we call him healed. We call him delivered. We call him your servant, oh God. Called by your very name. We call him with the eyes to see you and ears to obey your voice. We call him to be planted in the house of the Lord. We call him into great worship and fellowship, oh God. We call him into a great testimony to even speak of your greatness and your goodness. We love you and we thank you, Lord God, because we understand only you can do this. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Only God can do this. And he gets all the glory and all the honor for great things that he has done. Amen. Glory to God. And glory to God. Hallelujah. You want to testify? Okay. You want to do it? Oh, you want to do it?
All right. We know that we are in service. We're a church. We take the church wherever we go, right? And right now we're in a park, so we're in service. But we can take the church wherever we go. Amen? So now that we done had service, we done had the word, I was supposed to do this earlier, I thought, but I think this is the point in time. And then we done had prayer. We've been prayed for. So after all of that, what we call the church is the hospital, right? And when we go to the hospital, what did the doctor give us to help us? A prescription, right? Okay. So the God gave me these prescriptions, so I'm just giving them out.
All right.
I'm just being obedient. Amen. You can write them down if you like. You can write them down and read them every day. And I think it's good for the soul. It's good for healing. Amen. So if you want to write any prescription down, I'm going to be obedient and I'm going to give them to you. And one more thing I was going to say. I was led to say what you read today when I was talking about we can't walk up perfect before God. And my spirit was to say what you read, but I didn't say it. But when you did it, I'm sitting there looking at you like yourself. Because the way we can walk up right before God and be perfect is those seven things. And God had that in my spirit to say when I was up here, but I didn't say it, but he had you to read it. And it was confirmation that I had to come back with this because I didn't finish. God is good. God moved in his own way. If a word don't go forth and you know that word was in your spirit, and then you hear that word right soon after that, I mean, that's confirmation that God is speaking. That's how he's building your faith, that what you're hearing and what comes in your spirit is truth. It's truth. Because if he put it in your spirit and you never hear it again, you'll be like, no, maybe that was nothing. But when you hear it again right after he put it in your spirit, amen. 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 Hallelujah. Amen. God is real. And we better get real with it. Okay, the first prescription is, y'all ready to write it down? Ephesians 1, 6 through 23. The second prescription is Psalms 112, 2 and 3, Isaiah 53 and 5, 54 and 13, all is in Isaiah, okay? Luke 4, 18, y'all got that? And then I'm going to just say this. One thing we can all can be sure of is that our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ will do just what he said he would do. And most of all, he would never leave us nor forsake us. He will always be there for us. He won't lie to us. Because he cannot lie. There is no lying. There is no untruth in God. God is truth. We can only expect truth because that's who he is. The truth. You see, man will fail you. They will disappoint you. But God will never fail you. So trust him. Lean on him. Believe and receive his word. It will bring life and hope for tomorrow and the future. So trust and believe. God, he won't lie. He is the truth. And that truth will stand forever until the end of time. And everything is going down. But the word, because the word is the truth. Amen. And it is of God. Amen? Amen. Okay, and I'm being obedient. And I thank God for this opportunity and thank you, Apostle, for letting me have this opportunity.
Amen. Glory to God. Next fifth Sunday, glory to God. I had made the decision this morning that when we do this again on the next fifth Sunday, which is in June, we will have our church picnic on that same day. So when we come together in this manner, instead of just coming together and having hot dogs, chips, and dessert, we will come together and have our picnic. So we'll spend the day. We'll have services, and then we'll just spend the day just bringing the pit on wheels, and we'll just make it a part of our picnic. Amen. We'll either be here at Apollo Park, or we'll be at that big park in my neighborhood. Amen. Now the ushers are going to come forth. Amen. Offering. Oh, she just reminded me to come and take our offering right quick. Glory be to God. How many hearts are, glory to God, glad you feel free? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. We thank God for a fresh expression of his spirit and that his glory rested upon us on this morning. Amen. We'll take our offering up quickly. And then we will dismiss. Our announcements are, while we're taking up offering, we know that we have our Good Friday services coming. Good Friday services is on August 18th. We have none other than Rabbi Taylor, who will be, we didn't bring it, just grab a bag. Just grab a Walmart bag. Rabbi Taylor will be the speaker. When we do our Good Friday service, it's April 18th at 4 p.m. We will have fellowship. It is such a sacred service. And that's when we also have our fish fry. We'll have fellowship, food, feasting, glory to God, and a good word, hallelujah. That's on April 18th on a Good Friday at 4 o'clock. And then our Open Heaven conference is April the 23rd, 24th, and 25th, I believe it is. And then we're closing out with a banquet on that Friday night, which is the 25th. Can you think of anything I missed? Bible study tomorrow night, glory to God, in the sanctuary, amen, at 7 p.m. Can I think of anything else?
Anybody else?
All right. Glory to God. Just point your hand this way. Father, we thank you for this offering, oh God. We lift it up to you just as Jesus took the two fishes and five loaves of bread and lifted up to heaven and it became much. Father, we thank you that little is much when you are in it. We thank you, Lord God, that your anointing is resting and ruling upon the finances of your people, and you're causing your blessings to run them down. Bring it forth, oh God. Bring forth a hundredfold return upon every seed that was sown in this offering on today. And Father, we thank you that every dime will be used to bring forth your kingdom in the earth to your glory and honor alone. And it is in your Son, Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Anything else I missed? If that's it, we'll dismiss. Glory to God. And then we'll just, I believe they got the grill going already. Amen.
Amen.
Father, we just thank you, Lord God, for this service that went forth thus far. All those that came out, glory to God, to fellowship with us, oh God. We ask that you all would rest and rule upon your people, Lord God, and that you would bless them in a mighty way. Father, always let the words of our mouth and the meditation of our lifestyle always be acceptable in your sight. You are our God. We are your children. You are our Lord and Savior. We love you and we praise you until we meet again. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Fellowship, love on somebody. I guess it'll take them a few minutes to get the